Sports science is a very competitive and, quite frankly, oversubscribed industry. So as a young professional, it can be challenging to navigate the job market and find the right opportunities for you. But with the right strategies and quite a bit of patience, you can set yourself up for success. My name is Jo Clubb. I'm a sports science consultant and I've worked in this field for more than 15 years. And here are my top tips for career development in sports science in 2023. As scientists, our work is never done. We need to be continuously educating ourselves. And there's no better time than the new year to build habits that will help you stay up to date with the latest research and trends in sports science. Whether that is making time each week to read textbooks or journal articles, or perhaps setting up alerts on topics in journal articles that are of interest to you, or maybe it's a consistent writing habit that you can create. Now is a great time to be building these habits that lay the foundation for continuous learning. But you also shouldn't just be consuming sports science literature alone. We can learn a lot from books and information outside of this domain as well. Some of the lessons I've taken have come from business or leadership or communication books. And some of the best books that I would recommend for this year are books like Think Again by Adam Grant and Range by David Epstein, and even the Great Mental Models series by Farnham Street. And as you're reading these, reflect upon what they mean to you and your role in sports science. But again, they are lessons that we can learn from outside of sports science. In 2023, the first thing anyone that you message or apply for a job or an internship with, the first thing they're going to do is Google you. They're going to go online and they're going to check out your presence there. So definitely a step worth doing is to audit your online presence. And this was reinforced just earlier this month with this thread on Twitter stating for George that the first place that he goes when hiring or recommending a strength coach is looking at their Twitter profile. And he's providing here some recommendations of how to clean up your profile and the things that he does or doesn't look for. But it's worth looking beyond Twitter as well. Is your Facebook profile public and what is available on there? Do you have a LinkedIn profile? And if not, why not? That is a really important platform for growing your network, especially as a young practitioner. What is available? You may use these platforms for personal reasons, but remember that this is going to be used like a search tool to look into who you are. So make sure that you are proud of everything that can be found online about you. Now, building on that, it is not just about cleaning up your online presence and trying to hide things, but how can you make your online presence also benefit you? And I think one of the key ways, and certainly something that's had an impact on my own career and my development, is sharing content online. Now, you have to think carefully about what that looks like, especially as a younger practitioner. But there's lots of opportunities to add value to the industry whilst also adding value and knowledge for yourself. For instance, perhaps those research articles that you are reading each week, you share online on Twitter so that others can get access and you're also building your network. Maybe you go a step further and share your own take or what you think the key message is. I think another great way of sharing valuable content online, as particularly as a younger practitioner, is if you have the opportunity to attend events, then sharing snapshots from the presentations, whether it's visual pictures or some of the key points that the speakers are making. Again, you are bringing value to our industry by sharing that content. Now, as a younger practitioner with a smaller network and a smaller online presence, of course, you may not at first get a wide reach on this content. But first and foremost, it is about internal benefits, the benefits it provides you by reflecting on this information, by sharing it, by sharing the key messages. And then thereafter, if it brings benefits to others, then great. So don't get caught up in the external validation of likes and retweets or anything, any of those external statistics, but do it as a benefit to you that may also help the wider industry. And a really key tip that is probably going to be a key tip in every single Career Insights video I do is around building your network. And if you are, as we previously said, sharing content online, then that is going to be one way of growing your network. But we're also connected internationally throughout the sports science community. So if you're reading on a particular topic or research, then reach out to those individuals with questions or comments on their work. Again, this networking concept that many cringe at is not about just getting your name out there and sending tons of emails or LinkedIn requests, but doing it in an authentic manner, bringing value to that other individual and building a genuine relationship with them through conversation and questions. As well as the online platforms, there are more and more of these sports science communities popping up, which have some cost often associated with them, but try to make it low cost but high value to you as young practitioners. So for instance, Steve Ingham's Supporting Champions community, Dan Howes has his Collaborate Sports Mentorship program, and Altis also in the US have Altis Connect as a community there. So that may be another way to build your network. But of course, now we're seeing more and more in-person events, which again, probably have costs associated with them, at least in terms of travel. But be sure if you do get to go along to any of them to make the most of them and also follow up afterwards and stay in touch with whether it's the people you met or the presenters that you saw speak. I hope those quick tips are helpful on your journey in sports science. Remember to keep learning, networking, and seeking those new opportunities, and you'll be well on your way to a successful and enjoyable career. Be patient and positive, and think of the long-term goals that you have. I hope you found this video useful. I'd love to hear from you if you did, or if you think there's any key tip that I missed out. And I'll see you again soon with another Career Insights video on the Global Performance Insights channel.